Greetings, friends and strangers alike. Welcome, one and all. I'm your friend, the Woodland Elf, and welcome back to Pokemon Leaf Green Nuzlocke Challenge. That's very hard to say in one go. Alright, so last time we boarded the SS Anne. Ship set sail. We can't go onto the docks to give a longing look at the departing cruise liner. It's a shame. Yeah, we went on the SS Anne, cleared out all the trainers on there and our rival, and got cut so that we are able to get through to the gym. Sandusky also evolved, which was a very big surprise for me because I completely forgot the level at which Sandra evolved. So that's fantastic because that gives us a real edge now in the gym because Sandusky is now much more powerful. Nothing else has changed, so I guess let's just get on with it. Yeah. Let's knock out this gym, first half of the episode, why not? Oh, let's get pumped for... Oh, shit. I walked out of the gym. Ah, and Burrito's been here before, as of course he has. Anyway, this guy. Yo, champ in the making. Lieutenant Surge has a nickname. People refer to him as the Lightning American. He's an expert on electric Pokemon. Bird and water type Pokemon match poorly against the electric type. Interesting that they put bird type instead of flying type. I think bird type was actually an original type they were going to code into the game. So like Pidgeotto here wouldn't be normal flying, she'd be normal bird. Which kind of makes sense actually, because there are a lot of flying type Pokemon that aren't birds. Anyway, so this gym is infamous in its puzzle. And that we gotta go rooting through the trash. I'm not gonna do that, however, I'm gonna go fighting some trainers. There's a sailor in here, which is kind of weird. Don't they usually come with, like, water Pokemon? A Pikachu! I got something for a Pikachu. Oh. Stop with the double team, you asshole. No! Stop! Stop! No! Oh, thank God. I'll fuck you with static. God damn it. Another Pikachu, huh? You... Fucking sit down to you, prick. I'm so sorry that I swear so much. Anyway, now we're gonna have to go heal that fucking paralysis off. Swearing immediately after saying I'm sorry for swearing. Alright, let's heal our Pokemon off. Sweet. Actually, did I come in here and get the old rod? I didn't. Well, now we've got the old rod. Fantastic. So now we can go catch a Magikarp whenever we want. I think that's actually the only thing you can catch with an old rod, is Magikarp. Which is not bad, because Gyarados is an amazing Pokemon, but... More electric types for Sandusky to wreck! Oh, baby. The XP he's getting in here is pretty good as well. Engineer Bailey, you down, boy. Oh. And we got an old man. Oh. Wait, did he sound like he was Lieutenant Surge's CEO, or Lieutenant Surge was his CEO? I don't know. Anyway, more fucking double-teaming Pokemon. Yeah. Slash, hell, yes I want Slash. Because that is basically an upgraded Scratch. And also has a high crit chance, which is ace. Anyway, yeah, we can't get past the lasers that Lieutenant Surge... that Lieutenant Surge has in place. And we got to go dig it through the trash. And what you got to do is you got to find two switches. And how this works is if you find one, the second switch will always be adjacent to it. So, for example, if there's a switch here. Damn it. Yeah, if there was a switch in this one, then it means that the second switch would either be in this one, or this one, I think. I'm not 100%. And if you pick wrong, the whole thing resets, so you have to find them again. Damn it! Okay, there's only these two left. What? I've searched every single trash can. What the hell? Surge, you devious bastard! Well, there we go. So... This one? Fuck! It's deceiving because you don't... You can search a trash can and it'll say, no, there's only trash here. But then, there suddenly might be trash in it now. Fuck! that there suddenly is a switch in it rather than trash. So it's deceiving. You might think, oh, I've checked that one. There's no switch in there. Nope, there could be a switch in there now. Why trash cans, Serge, you fucking asshole? Gotta go elbow deep in your shit to find a switch to open the lasers. Oh my god. Okay, I'm picking this one. Fuck! If I don't find it next time, I swear to Lucifer that I will scream. Okay. You! Fucking A! Serge, I'm coming for you, you bastard, for fucking me around. Okay, I actually want to see what kind of potions I'm rocking here. 10 potions, 3 super potions. I'm actually going to go back. Hopefully the fucking lasers don't reset if I leave the gym. I don't think they do. Mart is what I need. I've got some items to sell. Here, take this fucking X-Defend. Does anyone actually seriously use those items? They're useless. Sell my revive, because this is a Nuzlocke. Revives are useless to me. Ooh, Star Piece. It's basically a nugget minus $100. Stardust, nice 1k. X-Attack, fuck off. And buy. No, we're good on Pokeballs. Let's buy a lot more Super Potions. Antidotes, I'm good. Don't need any of this shit. Oh, repels. No, fuck it. Don't need no repels. Alright, so I think we're good now. Alright. So, pretty much, I'm just going to... This gym is all Sandowskis. I'm not even going to bother using anyone else. Oogway and Farah are both useless here anyway, because they're weak to it. Hornet, I can't see being much use. And Neil, I can't see being much use, other than for Sing. So this gym is going to be resting all on Sandowski's shoulders. His powerful, spiky shoulders. Anyway. Hey, kid, what do you think you're doing here? You want to live long in combat? Not with your puny power. I'll tell you what, kid. Let your Pokemon save me during the war. They zap my enemies into paralysis. The same as I'll do to you. Not a great American accent, I'll admit. Anyway, Leader Lieutenant Serge. Alright. Everything in this gym pretty much is just going to fall to dig in one shot, I would assume. Other than the last Pokemon. Hopefully this thing doesn't fucking double team. Oh, it went down. Fuck you. And here comes the big guns. The Raichu. The famous Raichu. Killed Pokemon in the show. Well, it didn't kill him, but... Yeah, and it's going to be using double team because that's pretty much the only thing it can do. Oh, and he gets one shot! Fuck you, Lieutenant Surgeon, your electric fucking double teaming Pokemon. Now that's a shocker. Nice. You're the real deal, kid. Fine, and take this Thunder Badge. Ho ho! The Thunder Badge grants up your Pokemon speed. Also lets your Pokemon fly lightning quick anytime, kid. You're special, take this. And that contains Shockwave, which we didn't even see in the gym because. They're never going to use it because you're coming with a ground type. It's so weird, like... That gym carries absolutely no counter to ground types whatsoever. So, pretty much, if you're struggling, just go into Diglett's Cave and catch a Diglett, and you've beat that gym, pretty much. Anyway, now that we beat the gym, this guy has appeared. Oh, hello, Elf. How are you doing? It's me, one of Professor Oak's aides. Did you meet the other aide? He had a package from Professor Oak for you, Elf. He said he'd look around Route 2 for you. Oh shit, I need to go on Route 2? Well, tickle my balls and call me Shirley. I need to go in the gym. At the gym, Route 2. And to get to Route 2, at least the part the aid is on, we need to go through Diglett's Cave. So let's go through Diglett's Cave. Let's battle some Diglett along the way. I don't think they can actually touch Farah because she's flying in the sky. Diglett's Cave is actually rather long and very annoying. Anyway, Farah is killing all these moles. Plucking them out of the ground. Like the predator that she is. Oh, nice level 25 Farah. Does that make Farah my highest level Pokemon now? I think it does, right? Yeah, it does. Fuck it, eh. That's always kind of a rarity in Pokemon games, is your starter not being your highest level Pokemon. just because it's with you for the longest time. Generally speaking, it's going to be your highest level. Anyway, this is how you get to Route 2, and if we cut our way through here, we can get back to Pewter Sitter. This part of Route 2 is inaccessible to you until you get cut. Well, it's not. You can go through Diglett's Cave like I just did. Anyway, come in here. Found a Pokemon, yeah, whatever. And here's a trade. If you have the Pokemon Abra, you can get a Mr. Mime here. I don't have an Abra, and if I did, I would not be trading it for a Mr. Mime. Because Kadabra slash Alakazam are way fucking better than Mr. Mime. Anyway, you. What's Pokemon with Slash? Yeah, and here's Professor Oak's aid. If you if you catch 10 Pokemon, or a complete data on 10 species, you get a reward, which I think I do, right? 14. So only just, holy fuck. And we get HMO5, which is Flash, which we need for an upcoming give. Some items down here as well. Ether, Paralyze Heal, and there could be a hidden item here, but fuck it, I'm not searching for it. We don't have the item finder. And if I cut here, I could head back down to Viridian City. I'm on the road to Viridian City. I'm on the road, I'm on my way. Oh, we can cut this guy now. And here is a move tutor that teaches you Dream Eater, should you want it. Neil can learn that, that's interesting. We're not going to teach that to Neil because that's... Dream Eater is a very powerful move. It's like 100 pace power psychic move, but comes with a drawback in that it only works when the Pokemon is asleep. So, when the target is asleep, should I say. So, that is useless to us. I mean, Clefairy does have Sing, so he could well utilize Dream Eater, but it's not... Oh, fuck it. We don't care. Oh, while I'm here, actually... While I'm in Pallet Town, Pewter City, we're going to... not growing the mark, holy fuck. We're going to go up to the museum and cut our way through to this side. I said earlier in the game that we would be coming here as soon as we got cut because we want this item right here. What does this guy say about it?
Shh, listen. I need to share a secret with someone. I think that this chunk of amber contains Pokemon DNA. It would be shattering specific pain through if Pokemon could be resurrected from it. But my colleagues just ignore what I have to say. So I have a favor to ask. I want you to get this examined in the Pokemon lab somewhere.
Old Amber, your boy. Examine at a Pokemon lab, you say? Is there not a lab right here? Nope, we take that to the Pokemon lab on Cinnabar Island, and that will transform into an Aerodactyl, which is a fantastic Pokemon. I may use it. Totally depends on whether Farah's still alive by that point. I mean, I know I have Olena in the bank as well. And actually, I have another Pidgey in the bank, don't I? What did I name that other Pidgey? I've completely forgot. Yeah, I still have another Pidgey and a Spearow in the bank, so... Get out of here, Magnitude Diglett. So I've got no shortage of flying types. But I may still use Aerodactyl come the end of the game anyway. When we get it near the end of the game, so I should say, because it's a very, very powerful Pokemon. Anyway, Farah, stop destroying all these Diglets, will you? They're already dead, Farah. Christ, I'm killing him. Another one bites the dust. Dum dum dum, another one bites the dust, another one bites the dust, hey! Oh, that aid's gone now. I suppose he's literally just there to tell you to go to Route 2. I think the game just expects you to go there as soon as you get to Diglett's Cave, which I didn't. Anyway, so right now our objective is actually to go all the way back up to Cerulean City. I don't actually know if the game tells you that's where you're supposed to be going. But if we tried to get into Saffron City, you saw the exit for it, right here. You actually can't get into Saffron City right now because the guard is thirsty. Like, dude, I don't give a fuck if you're thirsty. You don't get to close the gate to a city because you want a fucking drink. So weird. Anyway, yeah, now we're back in Cerulean City and we might as well grab the bike while we're here. Fuck it, why not? Let's grab that $1 million bike. Christ, I wonder how fast we can go on the bike now. with the speed up. Holy shit, we're gonna be like the Flash. Like, oh, look at this. Holy shit, so quick. Ah! Yeah, we're not gonna be using that. But we just got it just because. Man, this guy hasn't cleaned up his fucking house yet. Dude, get off your ass and fix the hole in the wall. Jesus. Alright, so on to the next route then, because this is now our port of call. Route 9. We can actually catch a new Pokemon here too. After we destroy this little girl. Who do I want to be leveling up right now? Well, it's Neil, I guess. Lowest level, why not? Oddish. I got something for that ass. It's called a very angry, rugged space man who can punch people in the face. Yeah. Oh, damn it. I suppose that would have been coming at some point. Neil, wake up. This, I don't actually think this Oddish can do anything. I think all he carries is the 3 powder moves and sweet scent, so he literally can't touch you. Bellsprout can touch us, though, but Bellsprout is an absolute pussy that falls in one shot, almost. And we got fucking poisoned. Christ. Yeah, poison is the silent killer in a Nuzlocke. Because you get poisoned and you don't have an antidote or something. That's fun, because now you're running back to a Pokemon Center without tick damage. Anyway, let's continue on. Oh. Aerialis. Ooh. Can anyone learn that? I imagine Pharah could, but... Eh. Yeah. Hornet can learn it. Sandusky can look. Whoa! Diglett can learn Aerialis. How? I know Aerialis is just described as an extremely fast attack, and Diglett is an extremely fast Pokemon. But it's a flying move. Why the fuck can a Diglett learn Aerialis? We're going to hang on to that. That might come in use later in the game. Hiker, huh? You're going to have some fighting Pokemon. That's not Neil's game. That's Hornet's game, though. Oh, shit. Got that Seismikatas. An Onix, that is Oogway. Yeah, fuck you. Rapid Spin. No, we're not going to learn Rapid Spin. That's actually a very, very good move in competitive play. Because Rapid Spin is... It's a very weak attack, but what it does is it removes entry hazards. And entry hazards are extremely popular in online play, so Rapid Spin's a very good move. Not so much in game because the NPCs don't really use entry hazard moves. And I actually think the only entry hazard move in the game at this point is Spikes. I think. I know Stealth Rocks definitely doesn't exist. I'm not sure about Toxic Spikes. Electro Web doesn't exist. So it's literally fucking pointless. Anyway, Neil, you're getting your ass kicked by a little salamander. Jesus. We're going to take care of this shit. Anyway, come on and do the thunder. Do. Alright, let's heal up Hornet and Neil. Instead of bitching out and running all the way back to the Pokemon Center. Oh, you! Oh shit, a Beedrill. I don't like that. Pharah. Fury attack. Ah! Oh, no, not tackle. Shit. Turns out tackle was a good move to do. Damn! I know that was a crit, but damn, Pharah! You are going absolute hamburger on these Beedrill. Jesus, nice! Fuck you, bug catcher Brent. Anyway, Route 9. Ooh, there's a Pokemon I can catch here, yes. Let's find out. It's a Rattata. And the rules of the Nuzlocke just dictate that I have to catch this Rattata. Because I am employing a variant of Dupe Claws. Which is, I can only I can only employ dupe clones if I've already caught two of a Pokemon. And since I've only caught one Rattata before now, I still have to catch this Rattata. Although it does mean now that if I see another Rattata in the game, I will employ dupe clones and go for another Pokemon. Anyway, what should we call you? Ooh. A rat, huh? Oh, what was the name of the... Oh, yes. I hope this fits. Yeah, it will. Yeah, let's name him Splinter after the rat karate master from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Probably not going to use him, to be honest, because even if Joy was still alive, he'd probably be coming to the end of his usefulness around now. Anyway, so that Rattata is just going to stay in the bank as a spare, I think. Fucking Rattata, man. Christ. Oh, another bug catcher, huh? You shall fall prey to my fara. Play nice. Play fara. I do love playing fara on Overwatch. Particularly on King of the Hill, on Ilios. I think it's pronounced Ilios. I am fantastic as a Pharah on that map. Because what I love to do as Pharah is basically I'm perimeter check. I run the flanks. And Ilios, if you don't know, is a map with a lot of areas where you can blast an enemy off the edge of the map. And Pharah comes equipped with an ability to knock back enemies, so I love running the perimeter, waiting for someone to go for the flank, and then knocking them off the edge. It's fantastic. Because being blasted off the edge of the map is the worst fucking way to die in Overwatch. So I love doing it to other people, it's so fun. It's like the only map I like to play Pharah on, to be honest, Ilios. Well, that's not true, actually. I like to play her on Nepal as well. Particularly Nepal Sanctuary. That is a good area for a Pharah, that. Anyway, enough talk about the Overwatch meta. Let's continue with this game, shall we? Oogway. Not Oogway, you're a Hornet. Anyway, there's a hidden berry there, see it? Chesto berry! Fantastic. Oh. See that? I had some skills to get past that hiker. Anyway, we don't like Geodude on these parts. I am going to start to get quite scared of Geodudes later in the game because I'm not sure what level it is, but they start to learn self-destruct. So that Geodudes are going to become really, really scary later in the game because we have no counter to a self-destruct. We have nothing that resists normal types. We don't have a ghost type. We don't have a Pokemon with damp ability. Nothing. So Geodude is going to become very, very scary for us later in the game. Caitlin, you had nothing but a Meowth. Ah, nope. Ooh, Route 10. I could potentially get a very, very, very useful Pokemon here. Let's test our luck, shall we? Neil, you're our go-to for catching Pokemon. Yes! Voltorb, that's what I wanted. Voltorb, that is fantastic. Oh, it's got soundproof, so I can't use Sing. Fuck. Alright. This gun's not going to hurt me too much anyway. Just don't kill it. Holy fuck, do not kill this Voltorb. Let's try and catch it from here. Fuck! I'm scared of the crit. Oh, nice, we got it. Fantastic. Yeah, we wanted Voltorb from this area because this is... It's not our earliest chance at an electric type. We could have got Pikachu from Viridian Forest, but from that point to this point, there was no electric Pokemon. This is the first one we could have got. So that is fantastic. What to name it? How about... It's round. Looks like a ball. How about we name it Kobe! That's actually a reference to the Nuzlocke comic. There's a... When the main character goes to the Saffron gym, there's a picture of him dribbling his electrode like a basketball. And then when he wins, he's drawn the main character as Kobe Bryant. So that's pretty much the only reason that he's named Kobe. I don't fucking know. Oh, this guy gives us an Everstone if we've got 20 Pokemon. Do I have 20? No, I've got 15. I don't want the Everstone anyway. Everstone's fucking useless. Well, it's not. It's good if you want to... Oh, Jillia, that's what I called my Pidgeot. I forgot about that. Anyway, Kobe, welcome to the team. Bottles, get the fuck down. Oh, an electric type, that's fantastic. Really rounds off the team now, because now it gives us a solid Pokemon to use against both flying and water, which we previously don't really have an answer to. So that's fantastic. Anyone else here say anything? The nugget is useless, so I sold it for 5 grand. It's clearly not useless, as in it, you fucking dillweed. Yeah. Ghosts, huh? Ooh, spooky. Spoopy. What was I saying? I don't know. Completely forgot. Alright, so let's get training up Kobe. Pikachu is not a good way to be doing that. Sandowski is going to come kill this thing. Yeah, Kobe's really low level compared to the rest of the team now. So he's going to need a little bit of baby. Well, I say he. Voltorb's actually genderless. So... Actually, I don't think this Clefairy is going to have anything to really damage me. But I'm not willing to take that risk. Fuck it, no. I was thinking Clefairy is dangerous because of my Clefairy has Mega Punch, but obviously the enemy Clefairy don't. A Cherry Bearer, sweet. Alright, so we are standing here. I'm standing here outside Rock Tunnel, a detour to Lavender Town, where Forever the Elf is going to be making his journey on his quest for all the Pokemon Gym Badges. Sorry, turn into a reporter for a second there. Yeah, I'm standing outside Rock Tunnel, but that's pretty much I'm going to call the episode there. Next time we're going to explore that place and head on to the ghostly town of Lavender. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!